The Philippine Justice Department clarifies the U.S. has not made any extradition request yet for embattled televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. The DOJ refused to comment on the unsealing of an arrest warrant by a U.S. court which handles the sex trafficking and smuggling cases of Quiboloy. But on Wednesday, the Justice Department overturned the Davao City prosecutor's dismissal of rape, human trafficking, and child abuse complaints against Quiboloy. DOJ spokesperson Mico Clavano says the department decided to resolve the cases after a year of verifying evidence and confirming the alleged victim's identity. It is still unclear how the government plans to juggle Quiboloy's charges here at home and the U.S. Quiboloy is currently on the FBI's most wanted list over sex trafficking, smuggling, and coercion charges. The American president also addressed concerns over his age. Biden is currently 81 years old. If re-elected in November, he will be 86 by the time he steps down from office.
I know it may not look like it, but I've been around a while. When you get to be my age, certain things become clearer than ever. My lifetime has taught me to embrace freedom and democracy, a future based on core values that have defined America: honesty, decency, dignity, equality, to respect everyone, to give everyone a fair shot, to give hate no safe harbor.
The Republican Party delivers a scathing response to President Biden's State of the Union speech. U.S. Senator Katie Britt called Biden's border policies a preventable disgrace. Britt also criticized the president's so-called Bidenomics, which she dubbed ineffective. She claims the Republican Party would give the children of America the future they deserve.
The American family needs to have a tough conversation, because the truth is, we're all worried about the future of our nation. The country we know and love seems to be slipping away, and it feels like the next generation will have fewer opportunities and less freedoms than we did. I worry my own children may not even get a shot at living their American dreams.
An American delegation led by U.S. Commerce Chief Gina Raimondo flies to the Philippines next week for a trade and investment mission. The Washington contingent will be in Manila for a two-day trip beginning March 11. That trade mission was promised by U.S. President Joe Biden to President Marcos during the latter's official visit to the U.S. last year. An official list from the White House show the delegation will include top executives from Google Asia Pacific, Microsoft, and United Airlines, among others. The president and CEO of the U.S. ASEAN Business Council, Ted Osayas, will also take part in the mission. Finally, the contingent will include Filipino-American rapper Alan Pineda, known as Apple the App, as founder of his own international foundation. Growing concerns over in Hong Kong as the city publishes its draft of a new national security law. The diplomatic and the financial world are keeping a close watch on developments in the special Chinese administrative region. The draft of the new security law made public Friday includes sweeping measures against treason, espionage, and external interference, among others. This has stoked fears among businesses who worry the tighter rules could further dent freedoms in the Asian financial hub. The city itself has already seen a crackdown on dissent in the previous years from mainland China. Hong Kong's Legislative Council opened debates on the bill Friday amid tight security. Pro-Beijing members of the council expect the bill to be passed by April, with the urging of Hong Kong's chief executive, John Lee.